Hello and welcome everybody. My name is Jana Lang and I am with the Hertie Institute for Clinical Brain Research in Tübingen in Germany. Our group has conducted several studies on ataxic movement characteristics in lab-based environments and more recently also using wearable sensors. Today I would like to present our work on the quantification of ataxia-related motor impairments in rodents and in humans using markerless video tracking with deep neural networks. With disease-modifying drugs on the horizon for cerebellar ataxias, quantitative motor biomarkers capturing disease progression and treatment response are highly warranted in preclinical as well as in clinical ataxia studies, in mouse models and in patients. Capturing ataxia-related motor features based on markerless video tracking presents a highly appealing approach since no particular movement sensors are necessary and video footage from motor experiments and clinical scores like the SARA score is widely available and can even be acquired in home settings, which is of particular importance in times of COVID-19. This approach is facilitated by recent advances in machine learning, allowing the identification of predefined landmarks and the estimation of human poses in video footage. In a recently published preclinical study, we examined a knock-in mouse model for spinocerebellar ataxia type 3, expressing 304 glutamines and representing gait ataxia and coordination deficits. We recorded SCA3 mice of different age and disease stages compared to age-matched wild types while performing the so-called beam balancing task. In this task, the mouse is positioned on a beam and then supposed to walk towards a wooden box at one end of the beam. We used DeepLabCut for markerless motion tracking, a software framework for animal pose estimation based on deep neural networks. We manually labeled the snout, the front and back paw on one body side, the belly and tail base, as well as the tail tip, in just 44 frames across three different videos. When extracting the marker trajectories of the front and back paw from the ready-trained neural network, we could already distinguish 9 months old SCA3 mice from wild-type mice by looking at the occurrence of paw falls or slips. By introducing a new parameter to quantify the rhythmicity of gait, the ROG, we found a significantly lower ROG in 9 months old SCA3 mice as compared to wild types. But interestingly, we also found a significantly lower ROG in just 3 months old SCA3 mice compared to wild types. This means that we were actually able to identify changes in beam balancing performance in just 3 months old SCA3 mice, where pure visual inspection did not reveal any abnormalities from normal wild-type behavior. In a complementary clinical pilot study, we investigated the capacity of our video-based motion analysis approach for capturing the assessment of the SARA score in ataxia patients. This time we used OpenPose, a deep learning framework for human pose estimation. Without any retraining, this neural network yields skeletal information about all humans visible in a video frame. Applying the OpenPose framework, we analyzed patient videos recorded at the German Center for Neurodegenerative Diseases in Bonn. Here we focused on both a paradigmatic lower limb item, the gait item, and an upper limb item, the nose finger test. Based on the extracted skeletal movements on gait video footage, we identified features revealing significant correlations to the SARA score, including the step width variability, the lateral body sway, and the arm swing. Analyzing the nose finger test, movement smoothness and jerkiness revealed significant correlations to the SARA score with a high effect size of 0.72. Taken together, our studies provide first evidence that video tracking methods can significantly contribute to the development of movement biomarkers for both preclinical and clinical trials, and are even applicable in data derived from home testing. And with this, I would like to conclude and thank you all for your attention and your interest in our research.